Look what I found, guys. Right behind me, a big sign saying running never felt better and an Asics logo. I'm at the right location. It's the Asics event. Let's go check it out. All right, guys, so I found the event place. It's right behind me, as you can see, the big arch community space there. Some food over here and lots of activities for the afternoon. Looking forward to doing all of them, but first I'm gonna drop my bag. Check out that massive stage right behind me. Here in that very lovely building, all Asics branded. Looking really good. Now right behind me we have the gait analysis. Basically you get your shoes, it's a Kayano 30 and a Nimbus 25, and you test the two of them on those lines here, blue lines, with some custom insoles that have 8 sensors on each, and then some special pod on the side of the shoe. And then you basically get to know which one of the Kayano 30 or Nimbus 25 is the best fit for you, for your gait, cycle, and for your foot strike. I'm looking forward to it. I really want to know if the Nimbus 25 is better for me than the Kayano 30, or if it's the other way around. Yeah, let's go.
And now we're going to take 50 steps of your run, yep. Capturing, and then we'll do an analysis of both shoes.
Okay.
See the Kayano and the Nimbus.
Awesome.
Great. Let's go. Is your gait line.
Yep.
We've probably not seen that for the first time. And as you've seen here, if you look at the where you hit the ground, it's more to the midfoot. So you're not a fully heel striker, so you're rather in the midfoot you land.
And when you compare those, that the two work really, really similar for me. None of them was really making a huge difference. I kind of prefer the Kayano because it feels a slightly bit firmer, and it's like, you know, a bit more structured in the midsole at least, which I prefer over the Nimbus. And I also would rather get a Kayano now instead of a Nimbus, because I already have the Nimbus, so that I can compare the two. That was the testing. It's really interesting, the company doing the insoles, going quite deep into the analysis. I got the report. I will try maybe to link it as a PDF in the description of the video so that you can go check it out, so you can have an idea of all the data that the connected insoles gathered during the test. There you go, next is product seating. I'm gonna go get my pair of Kayanos. Looking forward to it. Right, guys, here we are on the run. Marco from Tokyo, Sandra from Tokyo here. And yes, 7K, let's do it. All right, guys, halfway through the 7K run with the Kayano 30, feeling good?
Yeah, it's amazing. Oh my gosh.
The shoe feels very different from the Nimbus, so stay tuned for the update. We'll certainly compare them. Very interesting stuff. Run is done. 7K, 5 minutes per kilometer pace in the Kayano 30. A good shoe. I think it runs a bit short, but I need to confirm. Kind of felt a bit short. Had a good shower, and now I'm walking to tonight's barbecue with Asics. Looking forward to it. It's really good to be in Berlin. I really like Berlin for some reason. Maybe it's like connected to the Berlin Marathon that I did twice here. I don't know, but I just like the vibe of being here. So I'm just like enjoying also walking a bit in the street and joining the Asics people at the barbecue. I'm gonna show you a bit how it's looking. All right, I hope you enjoyed the Berlin footage. It was a great event. I just got back a couple of hours ago. Asics Kayano 30, what is there to know? What are the important facts and figures about the shoe? I'm gonna go to what really, you know, stands out and is different and makes this shoe different. First of all, sizing alert, the shoe runs really, really short. I would recommend you to go half up, if not even a full size up. I would definitely need half size up, and I think if I were in a shop, I would try a full size up.
So this is definitely something you need to consider. It's the new stability shoe by Asics for people who are moderate to, you know, high pronators. It comes with the new 4D guidance system right here. Why 4D? Because there are four elements that are improved on this shoe to make it more stable. First of all, the width of the platform, inherent stability. It's wider to make it more stable in the forefoot. That's very good. The length of the shoe, as you can see, it has an extended heel. It has that also different bevel here, and that also adds some stability at landing. You have more surface, more you know, volume on the foot on which to land, and that's the second one. The third one is the depth, and that's essentially what you can see here, the sculpture of the midsole on the two sides. It's concave here and convex here. Maybe I'm mistaken with the two words, I'm always a bit confused with them. The idea being that this is also helping you to have a bit more stability on the medial side, whereas you don't need that foam here on the lateral side. And last but not least, you have the fourth element, and that's here, the insert. It's a less dense foam, which is really, really surprising. You would expect, you know, like posting something a bit more firm. This is softer actually than the Flight Foam Blast Plus midsole that you have right here. And that's in order to help you bounce away from max pronation. So, you know, when you're pronating essentially like this, this is meant to like help you go away from that pronation phase and have your foot, your legs spend less time with that pronation angle. So basically you go to that pronation, that max pronation angle with a lower velocity thanks to the three first elements. And then thanks to that bounce your foam here, a bit softer, less dense, you go away from that max pronation angle quicker, and therefore you spend less time at that max pronation angle. Quite interesting, and I must admit the comfort of the shoe is really good, except that fit issue and that the length of the shoe, you know, again, I recommend going half up. The comfort is really good, reminiscent of the comfort of the Nimbus 25. Very, very good comfort. That's the first thing you notice when you put your foot in the shoe. It's a comfortable shoe. It's not super stable. I mean, it's stable, of course, but it's not like exaggerate, and it doesn't control your ride, which is good, which I prefer as a neutral runner. It's a bit dull and a bit firm for a ride, to be honest with you. So that's, I want to see if the Flight Foam Blast Plus breaks in and if it like loosens a bit. But for now, it's a bit dull, a bit firm. It feels like a denser version of Flight Foam Blast Plus compared to the Nimbus 25, which is a bit too mushy and too plush for me, but I almost prefer that slightly, you know, exaggeration of mushiness compared to that from a ride here. Oh yeah, and I didn't mention, but pure gel in the heel, just like Nimbus 25, you have some pure gel, 65% softer and bouncier compound in the heel. I cannot feel it either, just like in the Nimbus. I think the heel is comfortable, it's cushioned, but I'm not sure if it's the pure gel or the Flight Foam Blast Plus that makes the difference. So again, being transparent here with you. That's it, it's racing tomorrow, July 1st. You have links in the description to Top Running, Running Warehouse, all of the retailing partners on which you can find this shoe. There's also a link to Stride if you want to get a Stride pod to have power on when you're running. We'll come back to that in a few videos. We have something on that that's planned, but if you already want to get your Stride pod with a discount, there's also a link in the description. Thanks for using the links and supporting the channel. Enjoy your run today, enjoy your ride, and go beyond your limits. I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye, guys.